Space hotels with pools, gyms, bars, and gourmet food have been one of the most common fantasies shown in sci-fi space movies. Given that only 553 people have ever reached low Earth orbit, and only 24 people have gone past low Earth orbit, it seems like space hotels won't be a thing for decades, if not centuries. So, you might be surprised to hear that people may be staying in space hotels by the end of next year. If you think about it, we technically already have a space hotel, which is the ISS. Dozens of astronauts visit and stay on the ISS for extended periods of time every single year. According to Google though, a hotel is an establishment providing accommodations, meals, and other services for travelers and tourists. Since ISS astronauts are employees and crew members as opposed to travelers or tourists, we can't technically say that the ISS is a space hotel right now. It should be noted though that 7 private citizens have traveled to the ISS throughout history, meaning that the ISS has been a space hotel in the past. Surprisingly, NASA actually wants to make this a regular occurrence, as they announced that they were opening up the ISS for private visitors in June of 2019. NASA has been conducting experiments and research on the ISS for 2 decades at this point. They claim that there's still plenty of research to be done in low Earth orbit, but at the same time, they're looking to move on to bigger things like returning to the moon and building a lunar base. So, opening up the ISS for commercial tourism is unfortunately the early stages of NASA phasing out the ISS. Nonetheless, it does make for an extremely cool tourist destination in the meantime. NASA revealed that they would be allowing up to 4 private astronauts inside the station at a time, and they would be charging just $35,000 per day per visiting spacecraft. This means that you can send as many people as you can fit into a single rocket for the same daily price of $35,000. If you were to send a Starship filled with 100 passengers, each passenger would only be paying $350 per day. Given that only 4 private astronauts are allowed inside the space station at any given time though, it would be best to travel with a group of less than 10 people. Each visiting group will be allowed to stay at the ISS for up to 30 days, and NASA will accept 2 groups of visitors every single year. NASA was originally aiming to have private astronauts on board by the end of 2020, but clearly, that didn't happen. The problem is that though the price to rent out the ISS is actually extremely cheap, it's extremely difficult to source a rocket and fund a rocket launch. A startup called Axiom Space is working on accomplishing this though. In March of 2020, Axiom was actually able to book a Crew Dragon launch with SpaceX that was supposed to happen at the end of 2021. Since then, it has been pushed back to the start of 2022, but fortunately, there's no signs of the trip being cancelled or anything like that. The plan is to send 3 tourists on a 10-day trip to the ISS. 2 days will be spent in transit, but the tourists will have a full 8 days on board the ISS. Though the price to rent out the ISS for 8 days only comes out to a total of $280,000, when you throw in the cost of rocket launch, training, and everything else involved in sending tourists to space, we get a final price tag of $55 million per seat. 3 wealthy individuals have already booked the seats though. This includes Larry Connor, Mark Pathy, and Ayton Stibbe. Ironically, despite spending $165 million collectively, these men may not actually be the first to rent out the ISS. You may have heard that Tom Cruise is going to star in the first movie shot in space. In September of 2020, it was announced that Tom Cruise and director Doug Liman would be traveling to the ISS in October of 2021 to start filming. We haven't received any updates since then though, and it's very possible that this mission will be pushed back into 2022. When I said that the Axiom Group wouldn't be the first to rent out the ISS though, I wasn't talking about Tom Cruise. I was actually talking about Russia. You see, when Russia heard about the Tom Cruise space movie, they decided that they had to shoot a movie in space as well. Russia plans to send their own actress to space in October of 2021 to film a movie, and I have a feeling that Russia is much more dedicated in actually achieving that time frame, but we'll just have to wait and see. Anyway, getting back to the Axiom trip, though the tourists are free to just relax and enjoy the trip, they reveal that they're looking to conduct a plethora of experiments and educational activities. So, I guess it won't just be leisure after all. Aside from sending tourists to the ISS with the help of SpaceX, Axiom is looking to send tourists to their own space station. At the start of 2020, Axiom received a contract from NASA worth up to $140 million to build a commercial module for the ISS. The module is officially supposed to be used for research and other applications. The module is meant for commercial use though, so maybe it's meant for private research teams as well as tourists interested in conducting their own research. Aside from this research module, Axiom is also looking to add habitation and tourist modules onto the ISS as well. Adding dedicated habitation and tourist modules would complete the first steps in actually transitioning the ISS into a space hotel as opposed to simply being a research facility that regular people can visit. The first of these modules is expected to be launched in the second half of 2024, and Axiom hopes to continue adding modules throughout the second half of the decade. Eventually, as Axiom's additions to the ISS start to become too big, or NASA decides to deorbit the ISS, Axiom is looking to disconnect their modules from the ISS and from their own commercial space station. This would be the first space station dedicated to hosting private tourists and researchers. Axiom is not the only company looking to capitalize on space tourism, though. Another company with even grander visions is Voyager. Unlike the ISS and Axiom Space Station, which have components of research and education, Voyager is looking to build a space station completely dedicated to hospitality and tourism, and their design is literally straight out of a sci-fi movie. First of all, Voyager is attempting to simulate gravity, which no other space station has attempted to do. Just like the movies, Voyager plans to make a spinning station that will basically pin tourists to the walls of the station. The rotation is expected to simulate 1/6 of Earth's gravity, and all habitation and activity modules will have this simulated gravity. Voyager also understands that one of the main reasons that people want to visit space is to experience weightlessness, so they have arranged a solution for this as well. Whenever you're not sleeping or chilling in one of their habitation modules, you can take the elevator to the center of the space station, which will offer a zero-gravity experience. In terms of safety, Voyager plans to incorporate 44 emergency return vehicles into their space station, which is basically one for each habitation module. These emergency return vehicles vaguely resemble NASA's space shuttle, and they will be capable of completing an automated flight back to Earth. As for amenities, Voyager is looking to match luxury hotels on Earth as much as possible. Their entry-level hotel suite offers 30 square meters or 320 square feet of living space. These suites will support up to 2 people and offer private bathrooms which include both toilets and showers. If you want something bigger, you can spring for the luxury villas, which are absolutely massive. Each villa is expected to have 500 square meters or 5,300 square feet of living space. These villas feature cooking facilities, 3 bathrooms, and can support up to 16 people each. Voyager is looking to provide a gym and activity module as well. They claim that these modules will be 7 meters tall and support basketball, weightlifting, and cardio. I don't think anyone visiting the space hotel is looking to get a serious workout in, but it would be quite interesting to try these tasks in an environment with 1/6 of gravity of Earth. Aside from a gym, Voyager is also looking to offer a restaurant and bar. Apparently, the restaurant will feature iconic astronaut food like freeze-dried ice cream, but they'll also serve gourmet food that is delivered to the station on a bi-weekly basis. The entire station is expected to offer a total of 11,600 square meters or 125,000 square feet of habitable space. This is enough to support 280 guests and 112 crew members. Considering the large capacity of the station, John Blinkow, the leader of the effort, is hoping to bus customers in using starships. That's all great and all, but when will it open and how much will it cost? Well, their goal is to open in 2027, so not that far from now. But the ticket price is of course quite high given the scope of the trip. Right now, a 3.5-day stay on the Voyager space station is expected to cost $5 million per person, and that's not including the starship ticket there and back. Now, it should be noted that visions like this in the past have not exactly panned out. Orion Span, for instance, pitched the idea of building a small tourist space station in 2018. Their vision was nowhere near as grand as Voyager's, but unfortunately, they were unable to raise enough money and they would end up returning all the money they raised and shutting down their project. This isn't to say that Voyager will fail, but simply that the process of building a space hotel is still extremely difficult. Nonetheless, with NASA opening up the ISS for space tourism, multiple companies working on space hotels, and rapid progress with Starship, I think it's just a matter of time until we see a full-on space hotel like Voyager envisions. Will we see it in the 2020s? Probably not. But will we see it in the 2030s? Quite possible. When do you guys think that we'll see full-on space hotels? Comment that down below. Also, drop a like if you guys would love to stay in a space hotel one day when the tickets are cheaper. And of course, consider joining our Discord community to suggest future video ideas, and consider subscribing to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.